So in today's session, we are going to continue with our discussion of the questions that we were solving yesterday, where we were actually solving an assessment test. So this is an extended version of that assessment test where we are going to incorporate some more questions of different areas. Right. So before we begin, let me quickly introduce myself. My name is Juhi Narula. I have 12 years of experience in training students for CAT, GMAT and GRE. I also happen to be a life skills coach and a content creator. I have done my bachelor's in technology and master's in business administration. So that's a quick about me. This is the Telegram channel. Please join the Telegram channel so that you get the notifications for all the upcoming sessions and classes. In case you've got any doubts, please feel to reach out. Hi, Nicole. Good to have you in the session. So apart from our wonderful sessions that we offer on an academy, which we call special classes that you are availing, and the sessions at YouTube on our channel CAT for MBA, we also offer you two subscriptions that we call Plus and Iconic. So in Plus subscription, there are live classes, there are weekly tests, there are study material provided, there's unlimited access to the batches, and the courses are structured. In Iconic, we have all the benefits of Plus. Apart from this, you have a personal coach who's going to handhold you in your entire journey of preparation. There's a detailed study planner which is provided. Then there's one-on-one live mentoring feature where you can get your doubts sorted by an expert. You can strategize, you know, you can do a call and you can share your screen. So there is a detailed test analysis done and there is expert guidance provided. So these are the benefits of Iconic. So let's see what is the, you know, subscription plan that suits you. You can choose accordingly. I personally feel that's an investment to you do for your own self. So let's now begin. This is the passage again coming from IIFT, and this is a lengthier one. So let's quickly read this particular page. Once you are done, you let me know. I'll move to the next paragraph. So this is split in three slides. Start doing it. Hi Shweta, hi Lavina, hi Nicole, everybody start doing it. I think IFT 2019. So start doing this particular passage, interesting one. And then there are two more paragraphs that we are going to read. Good morning, Shweta. God bless you. Please start reading. Read it, and once you are done, you let me know so that I can change the slide. Once you're done, you let me know, okay? We'll discuss it and quickly change the slide. Let's see. interesting new sort of a passage that you are going to see. You know, in IFT, it is known that, you know, the flavor of the passages remain to be very unique, very unconventional. So that's something you need to really work hard on. Okay, so Nicole is asking that what would be the strategy for VARC. If you are asking VARC, so Nicole, there's one term that we use, personal order of difficulty. So what do we mean by personal order of difficulty? That you work as per your strengths. So identify first the weak areas that you're struggling and the strengths. So both these aspects should be clear, and then perform accordingly. In case you find that my weak area is reading comprehension, then you can push that towards the last. Of course, that is absolutely right that you should always begin with the paper that you feel, solve those questions that feel remains to be your strength. So that is something that you need to keep in mind. Okay. So work on your strengths and start with the paper. And if you personally ask me, I think VA takes less time as compared to reading comprehension. That's a general trend that we have observed in the students. So you can begin with VA. Rest, you can decide where do you perform better. Okay, Nicole? I hope that helps. And rest of you, Shweta, Lavina, Nicole, have you read the passage? Most welcome, Nicole. Please feel free to ask your doubts. In fact, strategy should be worked on better. Okay, so Shweta has completed, Lavina has done. So let's quickly get started. So when we read this particular passage, a few years ago, I was on my boat with one of my employees, a great guy named Kinon. I was supposed to be giving him pep talk and performance review. When I think of what we do, I describe it as uncovering the riptide. So what is riptide? We don't know. So at times this can happen. This we call VIC. So a statement before and after can give you an understanding of what this particular word is. I said uncovering the riptide. Kinon said, yes, the idea is that you and I and everyone here have the skills to identify the psychological forces that are pulling us away from shore and use them to get somewhere more productive. So basically, what is riptide? That's more or less roughly being discussed here. Somewhere more productive, Kinon said. Exactly, I said, to a place where we can. We had talked for about 45 minutes when my son Brandon, who runs operations for the Black Swan Group, broke out laughing. So there is basically a story that is going on, and there are two characters that already three. In fact, I, Kenon, and the son Brandon have been introduced, where this fellow wanted to give a review, and then they talk about riptide, right? So this is, and then the definition of riptide is given. And then Brandon is the third character introduced, who's saying that, he's laughing. Let's see, what do you get further with the story? So I can't take it anymore. Don't you see, really, Dan? Don't you see, I blink. Did I see what? Asked him, all Kinon is doing is mirroring you, and he has been doing it for almost an hour. So that's the point of, so the question can come, why Brandon is laughing? So you know where to go back. Oh, I said, my face going red as Kinon began to laugh. He was totally right. Kinon had been playing with me the entire time, using the psychological tool that works most effectively with assertive guides like me, the mirror. So here it was mentioned riptide, and now here there's a technique, psychological technique, mirror being mentioned. Right, your personal negotiation style and that of your counterpart is formed through childhood, schooling, family, culture, and a million other factors. By recognizing it, you can identify your negotiating strengths and weaknesses and those of your counterpart, adjust your mindset and strategies accordingly. Negotiations, so this is basically more or less explaining that how mirroring works. Negotiation style is crucial variable in bargaining. If you don't know what instinct will tell you or the other side do in various circumstances, you'll have massive trouble gaming out effective strategies and tactics. You and your counterpart have habits of mind and behavior, and once you identify, you can leverage them in a strategic manner, just like Kenon did. So this is again how the negotiation is important in the discussion. So I hope the flow of the idea is clear, that it begins with talking about riptude. Then there are two people who are into the conversation. Then the discussion further moves to the third character being introduced, Brandon. Now, Brandon's role is to make his father aware that he has been mirrored. Then the importance of mirroring has been talked about. And then in the end, why and how negotiation is important, that is being discussed. Am I making sense to everybody who has read this passage? So if it is clear, then we can go to the next one. This passage has been previously tested in IFT, so an important one. Can we move to the next passage? Shweta, Nicole, Lavina, Rohit, Swamiti, Paithik, you joined a little late. Any doubts so far? Okay, thank you for the response. Let's quickly read this. Thank you so much, Lavina. Thank you, Shweta. Let's read this. Hi, Leil. Good morning. So we are doing one passage, one paragraph we have read. The next one are we on? So that's what's going in the class. Good morning, Bitte. I'm good, Leil. Thank you. Hope you're doing well too. Great, wonderful, glad to know that. So once you are done, you let me know, I'll change the slide. Okay, Shweta is done. This is the first paragraph, Rohit. If you want, you can quickly read it. Do it quickly because other students have already read, right? Quickly read it. Leil, you can also read it. Okay, Leil has done. Rohit, you let me know once you are done reading. Okay, wonderful. So this was the next one. There is an entire library onto itself of research into archetypes and behavioral profiles of all possible people you are bound to meet at a negotiation table. So initially, if you remember, the previous paragraph was talking about negotiations. It's flat out overwhelming so much that it loses utility. Over the last few years, in an effort primarily led by my son Brandon, so Brandon is again in the picture, we have consolidated and simplified all that research, cross-referencing it with our experience in the field and case studies of our business. So practically, they have done a lot of research. So how the research has been done, on what all people research has been done, the question comes, you know where to go back. Some people are, so now they're saying that, found that people fall in three categories. So three categories have been talked about here. So in case the question comes, what are the three categories the author has discussed, we can come here. Assertive. So one is, some people are accommodators. others are assertive, and the rest are data loving analyst. So there are three categories being introduced. I think a simple paragraph just talking about the research they have done and what the three categories they have created, right? So let's quickly move to the last paragraph. It's not a story, it is just the characters being introduced to, you know, explain a particular thought process. So not entirely a story, but the movement is like two characters working together, three in fact. Hi Ansh, good morning bete, God bless you. So we are doing one passage, this is the third paragraph. So I'll do one thing, once everybody reads it, you can quickly go back maybe later, but let everybody finish with reading this particular passage, then I'll take you quickly back. Hi Sheetal, good to have you. So we are doing the reading comprehension, two passages, paragraphs we have read. We are on the third one. So when everybody is done reading, then I'll take you back to the previous two ones, Ansh and Sheetal, both of you. Okay, Naman has also joined. Okay, Lavina has done. Let's wait for one more response before we start with the discussion. Rohit, what about you, done? Okay, let's read it. Then accommodators think that as long as, so in the previous paragraph, they were talking about that there are three broad categories. So that, then the three categories were accommodators, assertive people, and analysts. Now they're explaining that. So accommodators think that as long as there is a free flowing continuous, yeah, that I understand, Lavina. That is the reason, I'm not splitting. I'm trying to keep it a little, how do we go about it? Maybe you practice a lot of passages on the screen and that's how this problem you'll be able to overcome, right? So accommodators think as long as there is a free flowing continuous exchange of information, time is being well spent. So the thought process of accommodators has been explained. They will yield a concession to appease or acquiesce and hope the other side reciprocates. So basically, this is nothing but how accommodators think that has been talked about. Now, the assertive type. So now assertive type people have been talked about. Believe time is money. For them, getting the solution perfect isn't as important as it is getting done. So again, assertives are talked about. And assertives are fiery people who love winning and even at the expense of others. Third, analysts have been explained. Are methodical and diligent. They are not believed that as long as their self-image is linked to minimize working towards the best result in a thorough and systematic way, time mistakes. Their motto is as much time as it takes to get it right. Okay, so we have been discussing that what are the three, type of people, three broad categories, and those broad categories have been explained in detail. So a study of American lawyer negotiators found that 65% of attorneys from US studies used a cooperative style, with only 24% were truly assertive. So how the division happens, right? And when these lawyers were graded for effectiveness, more than 75% of the effective group came from cooperative study. Only 12% were assertive. So if you're not assertive, don't despair. Blunt assertion is actually counterproductive. So how assertion doesn't work in some situations, that has been talked about. Remember, your personal negotiating style is not a straight jacket. No one is exclusively one style. So if I say I'm just an accommodator, I'm just an assertive person, or I'm just an analyst, this doesn't happen. Most of us have the capacity to throttle up our non-dominant styles should the situation call for it. So I can act accordingly as per the situation demands. But there is one basic truth about a successive bargaining style. So what is that? Be good, to be good, you have to learn to be yourself at the bargaining table. To be great, you have to add your strengths, not replace them. So you have to give your best. That's the passage talking all about. So let's quickly take a gist of the discussion. Meanwhile, everybody who has joined new can quickly read this particular paragraph. So this paragraph begins where, you know, there are two characters. One, of course, who's writing, the author, and he meets with another employee, Kenon. And Kenon and this fellow, they are having a discussion where this fellow is supposed to give a, you know, prep talk and performance review. They talk about reptude, what is reptude, that has been discussed. Then the third character, Brandon, is introduced, who laughs and he says that you are not observing, but Kenon is actually, you know, mirroring you. Then what is mirroring, that has been talked about. And the last paragraph, they are talking about that how negotiation is important and the skill set is needed. So once people who have joined the new, they have read it, you quickly type in the comment section so that I can change the slide. So specifically for Sunny, Raghav, Rohit, who has already read it, Naman and Sheetal and Ansh. Quickly read it. Other students have already read it, so we are waiting for you only. Okay, so there's one thumbs up that has come. Now, who's actually, the thumbs up comes, but we don't know who has done the paragraph, who has done the reading. Okay, I'm just done. Sheetal, have you done? Sunny, Raghav, have you done? Okay, Lavin has already done. Okay. Okay, Sheetal has done. Naman, done? Okay, read it quickly. Quickly read it. Okay, let's quickly come to the next paragraph. Now, this paragraph shows that they have done a lot of research and then they have categorized people in three categories: accommodators, assertive, and data loving analyst. So quickly read it, everybody who joined late, and then we move to the third one. Third, everybody read it together, so there should not be any problem. Okay, so I would generally want to know that tomorrow at 8, we are doing reading comprehension. Arch type means important. Arch is the root for important. Okay, arch enemy, main enemy. Okay, what would you like to begin now? Since the assessment has happened, I feel that, you know, reading comprehension, we are still able to tackle well, and para jumbles, we are able to tackle well. So you have this option: either we see, start with an entire detailed series of sentence correction for the coming few days. In detail, we talk about all the nitty-gritties. This is one choice. We talk about sentence completion. This is another choice that you have. And third is that we continue doing mixed bag set for some time so that you are sufficiently exposed. So your votes, please. Or maybe the fourth one can be that, you know, we pick up, because CR para jumbles we have already done in detail. One is that we basically, you know, do a mixed bag set, sentence completion, sentence correction, and then mix back. So you would want me to pick sentence correction. How many of you would go for sentence correction? So let me know how many of you would be interested if we start with a series of sentence correction, or else is that we do some questions of summary and odd one out, some previous year questions. So you have these four options on your screen, everybody. So from tomorrow, would you want me to do a detailed course on sentence correction? You would want me to pick some sentence completion questions, mixed bag, or odd one out? So I'll create a poll quickly. Let me know what would you want me to do. So I'm just putting the answer to be A. It is just that, you know, that's not the only response. So wherever we get the major percentage, we'll start with that. So let's quickly do it. So the first option is sentence correction, B is sentence completion, third is mixed bag, and D is summary questions. Okay, so the 14% to go for sentence correction. Nobody wants to do sentence completion, so that we are not doing. Rest mixed bag and summary have got the mixed response, so equal response. So what do? We do summary or we do mixed bag now? For this, the percentage is same. So how do we go about it? Okay, Vasu is going to answer. Then Vasu has joined. Okay, so now we have... So there can be only... now the poll can happen between true and false. So if you want to go for mixed bag, then you write true. In case if you want to go for summary, then we can go for false. So however you like, I'll just quickly do a poll again. Okay. And this has come out a little straight. So 71% of the students want to go for mixed bag. Okay. So let's continue with our assessment sessions only. So we'll continue with mixed bag, and then maybe the next week we can start with sentence correction. I hope it is okay, Lavina. Majority of the students are saying mixed bag. Maybe I'll do one thing. I'll incorporate more summary questions and, you know, odd one out questions and sentence correction questions in the classes. Make sense? Is this clear? Theek hai, chalo. Very good. So here the three categories have been talked about. The next one, this I think most of us read it together. So accommodators, analysts, and how the, you know, assertive people work, that is the entire passage all about. So I hope we are clear with the passages, everybody. I think most of you were there when we were reading this particular paragraph. Okay, so can we move to the questions now? Let's end ka matlab kya hai, Naman? You are joined at this point. You want to read it? Okay, read it quickly, read it so that we move to the questions. So basically, you can see they're talking about how accommodators' thought process works, how assertive people's process works, and how analysts work, right? And then they are giving you certain statistics, and end they say that what matters is that you play with your strengths. So which of the following statement is correct? With respect to the passage, identify which of the following statement is correct. One's personal negotiation style and that of one counterpart is genetically transmitted. Can we say that? Should we keep A or eliminate it? No. So Ansh says eliminate it. Okay. E to hai ni naman. Okay. Bargaining style is the outcome of interaction. No. Successful negotiators are good and mirroring others. No. Achha, E matlab eliminate. Okay. So ABC goes out and Lavina is right. We'll have D as the answer. To negotiate effectively, one has to understand the counterpart's normal. So yes, most of you answered it correctly. I hope it is clear to everybody who is attending the class. Rohit, Naman, Lavina, Ansh have answered. What about others? I hope it is clear. Chalo, good. Let's move to the next question then. finishing the negotiation is more important than getting it right. So this was Pooh's perspective. Thank you, Sheetal, for the response. So if you want, we can take you to the traits of analysts. So you can quickly read here. They have mentioned the traits. Maybe you'll be able to answer the question effectively. Done reading. Can I take you to the questions? Yeah, quickly see the options. So let me know what would be the correct answer. Correct, Shweta. Very good. C is the answer. Assertives. Good, Lavina. Rohit, not A, not analyst, but assertives. Got that, Rohit? Very good, Lavina. Good, Shweta. Ansh, I hope you've got C. Naman, whoever, Sheetal. Okay. Okay, great. I hope it is clear to everybody who's attending the class. Okay, come to the next question. Select the most appropriate title for this passage. So, hard bargaining tactics, what type of negotiator you are, punching back, using assertion without getting used to it. Ye to narrow ho jayega. The three types of leverage, again, not a good one. Hard bargaining tactics and what type of negotiator you are. Correct, Ansh. Good, Shweta. I hope everybody has got B as an answer. Good, Rohit. Naman, what is your answer? Okay. I hope it is clear. Very good. So most of you have answered it correctly. Now, see, you're actually solving. Good morning, Deepti. You're actually solving IFT questions with ease. Now, see, you have bright chances. Just channelize your energy properly. This is actually an IFT 2019 pattern. And see, most of you have got all the three questions correct out of the three that we have sought, and that's very promising. So, you know, this should give you some confidence. So, Deepti, we are doing an assessment session. So, we have done one reading comprehension. This is the last question. Koi baat nahi, Rohit, ek wrong hua hai, evaluate karo and then learn from it. Right? But at least you're getting this confidence that passages are manageable in the exam, right? So, try this. Every wasted minute, the wasted dollar is best associated with it. So Shweta is very quick to answer. Shweta has answered C. What about others for this question? If you want, I can take you back if you feel the need. हाँ तो अब उस केस में आप क्या कर सकते हो आप कल से क्या करेंगे लवना कल से ना हम टाइमर सेट कर देंगे ठीक है अंश सिंह टेक बैक हाँ पढ़ो पैसेज पढ़ो सो इफ यू विल सेट अ टाइमर मे बी यू विल बी एबल टू फील द प्रेशर यस ऑफ कोर्स प्रेशर एंड स्ट्रेस सो दे आर नो टू थिंग्स नोइंग द कॉन्सेप्ट्स एंड नोइंग द टेस्ट टेकिंग स्ट्रेटजीज यू हैव टू क्रिएट अ बैलेंस रोहित आई बी डन ओके शीतल हैज कम अप विद सी वेरी गुड शीतल रोहित डन बेटर रीडिंग द पैसेज ओके वेरी गुड बेटा सो लेट्स सी व्हाट आर द आंसर्स Very good, Ansh. Very good. I understand pressure. So even, you know, even if I will go to give the exam, I will also have the pressure, right? Good, Deepti. Very good. Correct, Rohit. C is absolutely right. Good, Deepti. Glad you're quick catching up quickly. So this was previously tested. There's another feature, ask a doubt on the app, start utilizing it, right? It's very interesting feature. So this is the Telegram channel. Stay connected in case I have to give any information. At least I have a medium to be in touch with you. Right. This was again tested in IIFT analogy. So see what would be the correct answer choice. Trace the relationship between the given words. So here you need to know both vocab and reasoning. So it's a question testing your both the dimensions. serene is calm, peaceful, and agitated is when you are anxious. Okay, so Shweta has come up with C. So these are opposites. Fatigue and weary would be synonyms, Ansh. These will be synonyms. We are looking for antonyms. So odious and pleasant, C would be the right answer. Okay. I hope this is clear to everybody. So serene and agitated, these are antonyms. So odious and pleasant fit the category. I hope it is clear to everybody. Okay. Thank you for the response. Let's move to this. So this is a pipe dream. So this is an idiom. Idioms and phrases, at times we really ignore them, but they really are cakewalk questions, because if you know them, it would not even take, 2 seconds to answer. Right. So it is very important that you pay attention to these questions. You need to invest at least 15 minutes on vocabulary and at least 10 minutes on idioms and phrases on everyday basis. Please do that if you have not started as yet. So the correct answer, anybody would like to answer? No, it's an impracticable dream, something which is not possible. So this is C is the answer. Correct, Naman. Sheetal, Deepti, very good. Ansh, it is not D, it is C. Okay. Very good. So can we move to the next? This is again tested in IFT, a sentence completion question. So solve this question and let me know what would be the correct answer. So it's far more easier with the type of questions that we have done, in the evening sessions. I think here we have not done much of sentence completion questions, but for our YouTube sessions, we have done a lot of questions, right? So Ansh has answered. Let's wait for a few more responses. Shweta has come up with an answer. Sunny has come up with D, and Shweta has come up with D. Bhushan has come up with B. So we have 3 answer choices. Naman has come up with A. So let's see. In dash of international matters, there's always an element of risk. Dash one might do. So in spite of international matters, so in spite of, there is no contradiction, Rishikesh, here. So in spite is a negative transition word. So B and D can eliminate. Come to A and C. So risk in whatever one might do, in doing one might do. So doing one might do is redundancy. So C goes out. So the correct answer is going to be A. Correct, Vivek, Deepti, Naman. So whoever answered D and B, I hope it is clear why it cannot be the answer. Right, there is no contradiction in spite of international matters. So there is in spite of working hard, the people could not be evacuated. Very good, Vivek. Yeah, actually are cracking IFT questions. Very good, Rohit. So that's the idea, I don't deliberately put that, I could put it in the bracket. There are, that's also a trend, but I don't do it and unnecessarily might create a stress. But, I feel like that it should be, you should be aware that what sort of questions you are solving. Okay. So you have to rearrange this in the meaningful paragraph. Cat previously asked question, start solving it. Para jumble. So tomorrow I'm keeping 2 sessions at 8 a.m. We are doing reading comprehension, previously asked question. And at 9 a.m. as the class has unanimously decided that we'll continue with our assessment sessions. So we are going to, special classes, Rishikesh. Plus classes are supposed to happen on Saturday and Sunday from 4 to 5:30 p.m. Okay. So tomorrow there are 2 special classes session at 8 a.m. We are doing reading comprehension, that's previously asked questions. So we'll pick, I think, to 2019 we have covered, so we can cover 2020. So I'll pick a passage from 2020. At 9 a.m. we are going to have an assessment session. So similarly, a mixed bag set of questions. Okay. So I hope to see you in both the sessions, everybody. We'll keep the sessions of 40 minutes, maybe like this, so that they are quick ones. Okay, Naman has said 1 and 4 can be a pair. Okay, let's see. Let's get some more answers. Okay, so Bhushan has given one answer. Is come. I'll just clear the board first. So Bhushan has come up with an answer 3, 2, 5, 1, 4. Okay. Let's wait for a few more answer choices. Okay, it's changed the answer 3, 2, 5, 4, 1. So the, now the answer is 3, 2, 5, 4, 1. Opening 3 hoga ya 5, okay. Okay, Rishikesh has come up with 3, 1, 4, 2, 5. Sunny has come up with 3, 5, 2, 1, 4. Rohit is saying 3, 5, 4, 1, 2. So we have got this answer 3, 2, 5, 4, 1, then 3, 1, 4, 2, 5. Okay, no problem. So any other answer 3, 5, 1, 4, 2. Okay, 3, 5, 1, 4, 2. Okay, this is nowhere. 3, 5, 1, 4, 2. So let's quickly get started now. Anybody who's still doing? Lavina, are you still doing? Sheetal? Kritigya? Shweta? Shweta is saying 5, 1, 4, 3, 2. Okay. So the process of handling down implies not a passive transfer, but some contestation in defining what exactly is to be handed down. Wherever Western scholars, so this cannot be a starting statement, looks like it's a discussion being taken forward. Wherever Western scholars have worked on the Indian past, the selection is even more apparent and inventing of a tradition much recognizable. So again, it looks like need to have a statement before it. Every generation selects what it requires from the past and makes its innovations some more than others. Okay, Ansha saying 4, 1, 3, 5, 2. Okay, so this can, let's move to this particular option. It is now a truism to say that traditions are not handed down unchanged, but are invented. Okay, so the process of handing down implies not a passive transfer, but some contestation in defining what exactly is to be handed. So clearly we can say that 4, 1 will be a mandatory pair and 4 will be followed by 1, because here the term has been introduced and 1 gives a detailing. Are we clear that Naman was right in the beginning saying that 4, 1 can be a mandatory pair? I hope everybody can see that. Now death as its opposite, so is tradition by default opposite of innovation. Okay, so now if you see,
We have statement 5 with us. Now, what do I do with 5? It can be a opening statement like some of you suggested. There was one statement that came up as, and then that it has been talked about. Now, some of you are going for 3. So there can be 2 answer choices, either 5 begins or 3 begins. Now, what do we do? We look for some more mandatory pairs. So 4 and 1, we are sure. Now we see that where do we place? Okay, so 3, 5, 4, 1, 2. This is one answer choice that has come. Now we'll see the other statements. Let's see. With 3 and 2, are we able to form a mandatory pair? Every generation selects what it requires from past and makes it innovation some more than others. Wherever Western philosophers, scholars have worked on the Indian past, the selection is more apparent. So are you able to see this 3 and 2 can be a mandatory pair? Everybody, are you able to see this or not? So 3, 2 can be a good mandatory pair. No. See, every generation select what it requires from the past and makes it innovate, makes its innovations some more than others. So every generation will, pick what it needs and innovate it, create it. Like, I'll take a matka from the past and I'll innovate it using a tap. That's what the sentence is saying. So wherever Western scholars have worked on the Indian past, the selection is even more apparent than inventing of a tradition. So how here we are saying that selection is and then innovation is there. So the Western scholars are talking about that in India, in Indian past, selection is more apparent and the inventing of tradition is much more recognizable. So that's what we are doing, right, Rishikesh? I hope it is clear now, everybody. 3-2 is a mandatory pair. 4-1 is a mandatory pair. Now, where do I place? So Rohit is saying 3-2, 5-4-1. So let's see 5 ka placement. So 5 ka placement, the best will come before 4. Is this making sense to everybody that, that most of the answers also reflected that 5 can be, best associated with 4. So we have now 2 sets. We have 5-4-1 and 3-2. First, let me know, are we having enough clarity on this? And then we are going to proceed further. Patao, quickly give me a thumbs up. Are we happy that 5-4-1 can act as a set and 3-2 can act as a set? Any doubts on this? Now we have 2 possibilities here. Either the answer can be 3-2, 5-4-1, right? Or the answer can be 5-4-1-3-2. Right, 5-4-1-3-2. So the entire battle narrows down to whether 3 can be a starting statement or 5 can be the starting statement. So if you see placing 5 after 2, would it make sense? You're talking about culture and then suddenly you come life and death type of an issue. Just see, you here, how do we associate? Like beginning, both can be convincing, but see where the placement works. So after 5-4 can come, but just imagine, is there any possibility of this combination there? So life and death and innovation, wouldn't that be a broader statement to begin the discussion with? What do you say, everybody? Just think on it a little deeply and let me know. Oh, beech mein life or death ek bar le aoge kya all of a sudden? Right, so Naman is saying yes. What about others? Shweta says yes. Do I make sense? I mean, you can't just out of nowhere include life and death, right? So yes, the correct combination is going very, you were very close. Most of the students were very close. It's just that a broader statement comes first because in between, if you're talking about life and death, that wouldn't make sense. So 5-4-1-3-2, this would be the correct answer. Now 3-2, many of you were able to reach. 5-4-1, many of you were able to reach. So this is the correct answer, okay? So let's do the next question again, asked in CAT before. So try solving it and let me know what would be the answer. It's raining hard from my end. So, might be some internet problem in between. I don't know. Just making you aware in case the class abruptly ends, you should know. Anyways, tomorrow we are meeting for 2 special classes in the morning. 8 a.m. we are going to do reading comprehension. So we have 2 choices. Either we go from the passage of IFT or we go from CAT. So I'll be, of course, doing a previous year passage. So let me know which passage would you want, IFT one or CAT one. So today we have done IFT. Let me know. So at 8 a.m. Okay, Rishikesh, Naman. So we have got more responses for CAT. So we do one passage from CAT. Done, Deepti. आई होप एवरीबडी ज्वाइंस एट 8 AM राइट. ठीक है डन. शीतल कैट से करेंगे एंड एट 9 AM वी आर डूइंग अनदर सेशन असेसमेंट सेशन. सो दिस वीक वी आर कंटिन्यूइंग विद आवर असेसमेंट सेशंस एज दैट्स व्हाट स्टूडेंट्स हैव यूनानिमसली डिसाइडेड. सो देयर आर टू सेशंस हैपनिंग टुमारो मॉर्निंग. इवनिंग अगेन वी आर सॉल्विंग सम रीडिंग कॉम्प्रिहेंशंस ऑन आवर यूट्यूब सेशन. सो यू कैन प्लीज ज्वाइन देयर ऑल्सो. Again, I do previous year passages only because I feel like, you know, that gives you a real picture. But the multiple objectives we are able to solve. So we are doing CAT passage at 8 AM. Please do join. And at 9 AM, we are doing previous year questions, assessment session. Okay, that's the plan for tomorrow. Okay, Rishikesh has already answered. So Rishikesh has come up with 5, 4, 2, 3, 1. Okay, let's wait for some more answer choices. Would take your time. Any more answers, or it's a lengthier one? You're taking time. Okay, Shweta has come up with an answer. She's saying 2, 3, 4, 5, 1. Okay, Bhushan has come up with 2, 4, 5, 3, 1. Lot of variations in the answers. Okay, Sheetal is saying 2, 4, 3, 1, 5. Lot of variations in the answer. 5, 5, 4, 2, 3, 1. Okay, this one answer that we have got common. 2, 3, 1, 4, 5. 2, 3, 1, 4, 5. Deepthi is coming with 2, 4, 3, 5, 1. Lot of answer choices. So let's start the discussion. This visual turn in social media has merely accentuated this announcing instinct of ours, enabling us with easy to create, easy to share, and easy to store, and easy to consume platform gadgets and apps. So this usual visual turn, so this has to have a statement before it, so that we need to check. There is absolutely nothing new about us framing the vision of who are of what we want visually or otherwise in a Facebook page, for example. So this is an example statement. Let's see if we can have it as a starting statement or we have a better statement. Turning the pages of most family albums, which belong to a period well before the digital dissemination of self-created and self-curated moments and images, would reconfirm the basic instinct of documenting our presence in a particular space on a significant occasion with others who matter. So, ye dekho, wouldn't three be a better statement and then two follows it? Are you able to see that this has been always in our system and this is that there is nothing new when we are doing it on Facebook? For example, are we able to see that 3-2 will be a mandatory pair? Quickly give me a thumbs up, everybody. So pehle 3 aega, then saying nothing new, and then this, and take an example of Facebook. I hope we are sorted here. I've got one response from Bunch, Ansh, and there's one thumbs up. I don't know what others feel here. But Naman, it would be 3-2, it would be, not 2-3, but 3-2. Okay. So Ansh is saying 3-2, 4-5-1. Good, Bhushan. Very good. We are empowered to book our faces and act as celebrities with our confinement of our respective friend list and communicate our activities, companionship and location with minimal clicks and touches. So, okay, now coming to this, what is unprecedented is not the desire to put out news feeds related to the self, but the ease with which this broadcast operation can now be executed, often provoking unanticipated responses from one's immediate location. So are you able to see that 4-5 will be a mandatory pair and of course 4 following 5? Are you able to see that 4-5 will be a mandatory pair? Rohit, it not be 5-4, it would be 4-5 beta. Rohit? Okay, so we have 3-2 and 4-5 sorted. Now this visual turn in social media has created. So in social media ke baad 2 ke baad ka place 1 ka placement can be best after statement 2, right? This visual turn in social media has merely accentuated this announcing instinct of ours, and then how the announcing instinct is working, that's explained by statement 4. So the correct combination would be 3-2-1-4-5. I hope this is clear to everybody. Okay, so Rishikesh is doubtful in 4-5. So see, we are empowered to book our faces and act as celebrities. One key position. Dekho Shweta, 3-2 fixed hai. Theek hai, ab uske baad unhone kaha, visual or otherwise. This visual turn in social media. So ye dekho, this visual turn ki baat 2 pe hui hai. Isliye 1 ka placement after 2 will fit in. I hope I've answered this correct. I hope it makes sense to you, Shweta. Now coming to Rishikesh, your doubt, dekho, we are this visual term, easy to create, easy to share. So iske baad we are empowered to book our faces and act as celebrities. So 1 ke baad 4 ka placement makes the most sense, Rishikesh. Dekho, how easy to create, and then they're saying that we can do this by all these activities. Do I make sense? So 1-4 ko mandatory kar loge, Rishikesh, to bhi question solve kar loge. Samajh mein aa gaya to Rishikesh and Shweta? Okay, Rishikesh says yes, Shweta. Okay, very good. So the correct answer is going to be 3-2-1-4-5. Okay, so this is your homework question, though I wanted to do it, but then the class time has, is almost about to get over. We will not be able to discuss. So I'll include this question in tomorrow's session. Please do this again. A previously tested question of CAT should be helpful. Now tomorrow we are meeting at 8 a.m. So I was planning odd one out or reading comprehension. What do you suggest? 8 p.m. YouTube sessions usually happen at 8 p.m. So Pooja, 9 a.m. we are continuing with our assessment sessions. So this is done. Now mujhe bata, 8 a.m. how many of you would like to go for odd one out or reading comprehension? I was planning odd one out. What do you say? Okay, Shweta, Ansh has said odd one out. Okay, Rishikesh says odd one out. One or two more responses. Okay, so everyone, but you have to be there at 8 a.m. Okay, so there are two sessions happening. Good. Okay, we will do odd one out. Okay, Deepti noted. 8 a.m. pe we are doing odd one out. 9 a.m. pe doing assessment session, right? And YouTube evening we are doing reading comprehension. So aap aajo, CAT ka hi previous year ke passage karenge aaj. So it should be, fun learning together. So these are the batches that have started. Mine has started from 28th August. So you can be a part. I will be taking classes on Saturdays and Sundays, 4 to 5:30 p.m. Okay, we'll be covering a comprehensive course on vocabulary and grammar. As far as the subscription plan is concerned, for Plus, we have plans for 6 months, 12 months, 18 months, and 24 months. The fees is already mentioned. You can use the code JNLIFE10 to get a 10% off on any of the subscriptions. Now, Iconic, I feel Iconic has, yes, today evening reading comprehension. Okay. And we'll do passage from CAT, previous year tested questions. Okay. So, Iconic, you have plans for 6 months, 12 months, or 24 months. Got more benefits and personalized approach, I think, would well better. Now, this is an amazing feature of mock test marathon that has been introduced in Iconic and Plus. You can enroll for this particular plan. Should be helpful. So, we have upgraded our Iconic subscription with an additional feature where you can get live mentoring for MBA aspirants. So, you can have a personalized learning experience. You can, you know, make a call with, you know, audio call, and you can share the screen. So, that's an amazing feature. And if you are enrolling within next few days on 12 and 24 month subscription, you are getting additional 3 month subscription free. Rohit, last question kara nahi hai. Aap kiski baat kar rahe ho? Para jumble ki baat kar rahe ho? A session is going to end in any time. Para jumble ka answer would be 3 to 1 4 5 Rohit. ठीक है 3 to 1 4 5 And then you can use the same code to enroll for the combats to get a 10% off on the subscriptions. And also, if you, any of your friend wants to unlock the special classes, the same code remains applicable. I hope you found the session useful. Let's see you in the evening, and tomorrow there are 2 sessions. I hope to see everybody in both the sessions. Okay, so please take care. God bless you. May God be the kindest to you. Work very, very hard and stay consistent. God bless. Take care.